Peter, everything good here? All right. Hey guys, I want to update you guys on a book that I'm reading, and obviously it deals with General Grant. I didn't know a lot about General Grant when I started the book, but there's many inspirational things in the book that I thought I would share with the group today. So I thought there's three takeaways from the book that I thought we could all learn from General Grant on. So number one was his tenacity, number two was his courage, and number three was his ability just to get done. Really, he played to his strengths. So here you have a person, and I thought I would just show an image of our general, of our president here. Here you have General Grant back in 1863, and this is a person that almost failed at everything that he did, right? This is a person from really a nondescript background that just continued to fail. This is a person that battled alcoholism as he went along through life. This is a person that was in tremendous debt. This is a person that failed in business after business. So you're thinking, how did this person become one of the greatest heroes in American history? Well, basically it all happened like in an 18 month period. He went from everything that I just said to one of the greatest generals, and then obviously he became president after that. Well, he had, number one, like we talked about, he had a lot of tenacity. So up until this point, he was in the United States military. He got basically kicked out of the United States military. He's going through all these struggles that we talked about with business. And then he came back into the military, and the kind of the backstory is general after general in the Army, I guess there weren't generals, but leaders after leaders in the Army just failed, and Lincoln just kept terminating these people. And this upstart, Grant at the time, you know, he's like in his early 40s, just is winning battle after battle after battle because he just had the fortitude, he had the tenacity to keep fighting and keep fighting. He just kept taking it to the Confederates and he just kept fighting. He did not give up. He just had a stomach for this. He just became just very famous for the situation. His courage was unlike any other. So here you have this young man that is in battle, and he's looking at maps, trying to figure out everything. For example, his aide in one of the battles, unfortunately, his head was just blown off, and Grant just continues to study the maps and just figure it all out. I kind of struggled. What do I tell the group here as far as probably the best way to think about Grant is he was just a badass. I mean, he was truly a badass. He was probably Clint Eastwood. He had complete courage. He did have a little bit of weakness when it came to public speaking for whatever reason. Later on in his career when he became president, you know, he had to struggle with that. Like his inaugural address was only 1,200 words, which is pretty small, and he just kind of read that. But he always had tremendous courage in everything that he did. He played to his strengths. Going into the Civil War, this is a war that changed all things. This was probably our first modern war that we ever had, and here you have an individual that read the paper back to front every day. You have an individual that just truly loved mathematics and could figure all that out. So as he was coming up in the military, he was a quartermaster. I'm not sure how much you guys know about quartermasters, but it's just so imperative, especially in modern warfare, that you have all that stuff figured out. The train system, everything that will provide the food for all the soldiers, the communication. So here General Grant is, and he had a war room, you know, at times, and he had all the telegraphs coming into him, and he was able to truly figure that stuff out and make everything happen. He played to his strengths. You know, he knew he didn't have necessarily the whole package, but he was just fantastic at math. He was fantastic at reading and comprehension. So he had so many great things. So how does that relate to us? How can we get some of General Grant in us? Well, I say, number one, hey, play to your strengths, right? We all know what our strengths are. You know, sometimes I think, well, maybe I work too much on my weaknesses or whatever. But it's a lot easier if you think about a snowball going down the hill. We all know what we're good at, right? So really focus, polish what you're good at is probably a good way to be inspired by President Grant. on that. And courage. You know, think back today on some of the stories that I told about President Grant, General Grant. He liked to go by the General for whatever reason. And he just had tremendous courage. We all have courage in us. You just have to dig deep inside, take the hill, make it happen for yourself. And above all else, guys, have tenacity. Think about President Grant, General Grant, and the tenacity that he had. It's just real easy to be on the sideline. Have fortitude, get in the game, and apply yourself. Thank you, guys.